welcome all, and none of you are welcome. I was just saying that to please Nick.
Well, you just ruined it.
Yeah, I know, that's right.
Ridiculous.
For the first fight of the night, guys, we have Wipeout versus Bitch Doctor. And Bitch Doctor was the kind of lucky to win against Mega Tento. She was a big old bitch against him. But you know what, Nick, you just talk about it, because she was a bitch.
I mean, I wouldn't use that terminology, but I do think Witch Doctor was overwhelmed in the last fight against Mega Tento. Got a lot of damage and got fortunate to get through the next round. I don't think this matchup against Wipeout is going to be... I don't think he's going to have the same fortune.
So you got a vertical spinner versus horizontal spinners. Will Witch Doctor be able to hit Wipeout?
I don't know. Wipeout's got such a good strategy of baiting a bot in and then spinning. He's got a wide range, and Witch Doctor, I think, is too slow to get in to Wipeout's, get in towards the chassis. So I think Wipeout's going to take this one. I think we're going to see a big upset today.
Good. I can't wait. Let's get down there and let's see the fucked up shit.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's robot fighting time! In the red square, if you thought Shufflebot Waiachi was slow, wait till you see his brother. Please welcome Wipeout! In the blue square, he causes more controversy than NFL players taking a peaceful knee. Please welcome Witch Doctor!
Box is locked, the lights are on, it's robot fighting time! With Doctor making his way across to meet Wipeout.
Can he get in before he spins?
Wipeout very patient, waiting till the very last second to start spinning. Very controlled with how he spins when he spins. And he takes a wheel off almost immediately! As Witch Doctor struggles to get near him! Big shots from Wipeout again! Teeth on the ground! Teeth flying off these robots!
Oh, it's getting ugly fast.
Witch Doctor trying his best to get near that chassis, but Wipeout is having none of it.
Well, just like we talked about, Witch Doctor can't get close to him.
He's doing everything he can, but he's just too slow. There goes part of the weaponry falling in the red square there. Now he's trying to shove Wipeout to the wall. More pieces flying off. Incredible stuff at the moment. Witch Doctor really struggling.
Major damage on Witch Doctor, but Wipeout's lost a few teeth.
There's parts, there's smoke. And now part of the front wedge is gone of Witch Doctor as Wipeout continues to pummel him with shots.
Can't do anything, Wipeout's in complete control.
Wipeout trying to now maybe time his attacks a little bit better. He has lost a lot of teeth. Witch Doctor trying to take advantage of that. Another shot from Wipeout. As Witch Doctor continues to smoke, another wheel is gone. Oh boy, it's getting so bad, the weapon's all gone too.
The floor is littered with Witch Doctor parts.
Have you ever seen anything like this? Have you ever seen the floor more littered with parts? There's a motor on the ground, I don't even know where that's come from.
Looks like Wipeout has only two teeth left of the six. That's not good, it must be a hillbilly.
Wipeout may only have a couple teeth left, but he has done all of the damage here. Surely those teeth will not get counted against him because he's been doing it in attacking motions. What can Witch Doctor do here, Cole?
Well, at this point, all Bitch Doctor can do is stay aggressive. Wipeout can't really attack because he's too slow in a hillbilly. So if Bitch Doctor can take those points, then maybe he can get lucky.
Another tooth falling off of Wipeout there. He is down to one, but Witch Doctor is weaponless and without two wheels, smoking heavily, and we still have 40 seconds left.
These two look all tuckered out like little toddlers after a day at the park.
Witch Doctor still coming at Wipeout, like you said, Cole, trying to get the aggression points at the very least, but I don't think there is anything last year's semi-finalist can do. Wipeout has been completely dominant, another wheel is gone! Witch Doctor is down to one with 15 seconds left.
Can he get a knockout? He doesn't have a long schlong.
Wipeout trying to get over the Witch Doctor to get a couple late shots and finish this. But it looks like we're going to the judges for a simple decision.
What a fight!
We'll come back with that decision after the break. welcome back to the BattleBots Reborn Cup. We're waiting the decision for Wipeout and Witch Doctor, and it was an absolute bloodbath, Cole. Talk us through it.
We wondered whether or not Witch Doctor could get his weapon into good spots without getting hit himself, and we saw earlier that he couldn't. Wipeout ate him alive like Nick on Friday night with his girlfriend, and I'm confident he's taking the upset here.
We're just going to ignore that weird comment you made and go down to the box for the official decision.
The results from the judges are in. The winner, by a 31-14 decision, is... Wipeout!
Well, no surprises there, Wipeout wiping out Witch Doctor, who is out of the competition.
Fight 2, we have Hyper Jacques versus Surgeon Doctor.
You'll never say a name right, will you?
No, it's more fun that way. Eh. Both of these bots took out big names in the last round, Nick.
They did. Hypershock made quick work of Mechavor, while Surgeon General took out Ghost Raptor, and both had some impressive wins. They looked very, very good. So this fight's going to be fun.
All right, who wins and why, Nick?
Now, I think Hypershock is going to have a very similar strategy against Mechavor, because he's facing another horizontal spinner. I think he's just going to charge him. He's going to go after that weapon motor, maybe even get a wheel if he's lucky. I think he's too sturdy, he's too quick, he's too powerful for Surgeon General to cope.
Alright. Bye, guys. We'll see you at the box.
Okay, that's better.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's robot fighting time! In the Red Square, powered by Red Bull and the Energizer Bunny, this bot knows only one strategy. Introducing Hyper Shock! In the blue square, the only reason he stops in the middle of a fight for a break is because you need one. Please welcome Surgeon General!
The box is locked, the lights are on, it's robot fighting time! Here we go, Hypershock immediately coming out to greet Surgeon General with a shot to the face.
He's able to sneak under that blade and get to the exposed motor.
Surgeon General has to be aware, he's got to be driving pretty well here. There's no motor to attack on the front of Hypershock as he goes skidding across the battle box floor. Hypershock trying to line up another attack, he's fighting at a very fast pace. Underneath Surgeon General, there's smoke.
Not looking good for the General.
He is in major peril early in this fight, and there goes the blade on cue. Surgeon General is weaponless, Hypershock in control.
We all knew what was coming. Hypershock is dominating this.
And now parts of the wheel guard just crumbling off of Surgeon General.
He's
here.
Crumbling like a muffin.
Took the words out of my mouth, Coleslaw. Those wheels are not safe anymore, and Hypershock has plenty of time to go after them. He's cornered Surgeon General, there goes the motor, and he flips Surgeon General for good measure.
Can't believe the motor outlasted the actual blade.
Hypershock underneath again. Surgeon General, well, they could tap out if they want, but they're still going for it, even though I think it's clear that they're going to lose. Another piece goes flying into the air there. A glee from Surgeon General, Hypershock going at one of the wheels.
I'm starting to think Hypershock is a title contender. Last year was decent, and he started this season off with another impressive win.
Hypershock is one of those kind of floaters. He's not the best, but he's not the worst. And he gets a wheel as he continues to rub this victory in the Surgeon General's face. Merciless from Hypershock. He's going in for the kill. And Surgeon General nearly eliminated, but not before losing his final wheel. And one last shot with the ass, Hypershock wins.
Domination for Hypershock.
Well, Cole, let's take a look at the replays. I don't even think Hypershock broke a sweat. This was quick and painful for Surgeon General.
Yeah, Hypershock showed early on his ability to throw Surgeon Doctor around and get good shots on the disc. Surgeon Doctor drove poorly as well and attacked foolishly. But I think he would have lost even if he was driving better.
Hypershock absolutely dominant, and Surgeon General crashes out yet again with a 1-1 record. Will he ever get back to the finals? I don't know. He just doesn't look the same. The competition's a lot better.
He's a shit.
Probably true. We'll be right back with the third fight of the night, right after this.
Ah! Oh my god! No! Boom! Oh shit! No! What?
Welcome back to Black Ice versus Stinger. Nick, that damn cannon.
Yep, that cannon did it again for Black Ice. A little bit of controversy in the last round against Brutus. Had to have a rematch after some game glitching. But Black Ice just looks so solid, doesn't he?
Black.
Yeah, exactly.
Black.
Exactly.
Can Stinger be the one to take him out?
I think so. Stinger's so fast, and there is no Shreemech on Black Ice. I think it's just going to be a question of how many Rams and flips Stinger needs. I'm gonna guess he'll get it on 2, maybe 3. But I think Stinger's got this. Yeah, how much? Alright.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's robot fighting time! In the red square, float like a butterfly, sting like when you pee. When he's done with you, you might want to get checked. Introducing Stinger! In the blue square, can't decide what weapon to give your bot? Screw it, pick them all. Here is Black Ice!
Boxes locked, the lights are on, it's robot fighting time! Stinger coming out aggressively as we expected, and already underneath Black Ice! Looking to throw him over and end this quick, but he's lost the bite there and he resets.
Big early warning shot there!
Now Stinger attacking again, Black Ice against the wall there. Stinger attacking again as Black Ice just sits.
Black Ice sitting in the corner, not sure if his drive is broken or not.
When Stinger moves in, and he gets flipped on this side!
Oh, he's absolutely bottled it!
Stinger's not gonna be able to get out of this! And Black Ice has free range to fire that cannon at the underside of Stinger! He's gonna get a knockout! Stinger's gonna go! He's out!
I can't believe what just happened, Nick.
It's absolutely stunning! Stinger has just bottled it! The worst bottle job we've seen in Cup history. Cole, what happened?
He may not have gotten the flip during the first exchange, but what he did was careless. Black Ice didn't want to leave the corner for some reason. Stinger allowed it. Got caught and got what he deserved.
Absolutely insane. Stinger crashes out. Black Ice is through again.
Well, Cole, I lost the bet. So what are we doing here? Okay. Yep, I have to give up my stash. Well, I'm going to go put some boxes in his car and we'll go to commercial and then we'll see you back and you'll see me pretty sad and maybe him fucked up. Don't go anywhere though. Welcome back to the BattleBots Reborn Cup. There's been a lot of action so far in the round of 32, and before we get into our final fight of the night, let's take a look at what else has been going on the left side of the bracket.
Well, so far in the round of 32, we've seen a couple dominant displays and one absolute upset that came out of nowhere, and the other fights so far have been the same. First up, Mortis took on Overkill. After exchanging a couple minor blows, it looked like Overkill gave himself the edge when he removed Mortis's flipper. But not long after, Mortis was able to take off one of Overkill's wheels, which helped him coast through to a judge's decision victory. one of this year's favorites, Yeti, took on the unpredictable Complete Control. Complete Control flipped Yeti on multiple occasions in the early stages, but too many direct shots to the drum took a toll on his weaponry, which eventually gave way and allowed Yeti to turn the fight around with a knockout. Newbie Helichopper stepped into the ring again, this time taking on the unbeaten Cup Season 1 champion, Bombshell. Bombshell decided to go with the horizontal spinner for this fight, and it broke into pieces fairly quickly as it wasn't able to cope with the strength of Helichopper's hammers. Helichopper cruising with another knockout. And finally, last year's runner-up, Beta, stepped into the ring to take on Poison Arrow. Poison Arrow used multiple strategies during the early stages of the fight to frustrate Beta and cause major damage to the side, even removing a ramp plate. But using his experience from last season, Beta kept his nerve, got some good shots to regain confidence, and eventually used his pin and hit technique to finish Poison Arrow.
And for fight four of the night, we got... Whoa, that's some shit. We got Warhead versus... Oh.
You can do it.
Warhead wasn't the most convincing against Omega 13.
He wasn't, but then again, it was Omega 13 that he fought, so you expect a tough fight there. Still expect a lot of Warhead in this tournament, though. He got the job done. He's here.
Mo of you think, do you so? Winner title potential, he has picked you who? Matador beat Mo?
Snap out of it. Try that again.
Yeah. Mo beat Minotaur, who you picked as a potential title winner. So who do you think of Mo? So what do you think of Mo?
Mo looks good. I can't lie. He's already two fights in, two wins in. A little shaky against Minotaur. If he takes off Warhead, though, he's a title contender. That's two title contenders he would have taken off himself, and you can't overlook that. So it's good for him. Let's see if he can do it again.
Ooh. Who wins?
You know, both bots are really strong, but Mo has an exposed motor there in the front, and I think Warhead's gonna chip that off pretty quick, and if Mo's weapon's done, that's it. We've seen Warhead defend well so many times, I think we're gonna see it again from him.
Mo Schmo.
Ready to see who wins?
I guess so.
Then we're going down to the box. See you there. Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's robot fighting time! In the red square, his defense like Joel Osteen's church doors are closed shut. Good luck breaking in against Warhead! In the blue square, he can keep Larry, Curly, and Shemp in line, so he'll have no problem taking you out. Introducing Mo!
The box is locked, the lights are on, it's robot fighting time! Both bots getting their weapons up to speed, Mo coming out quick with a big shot on Warhead. Warhead returning
two
the
huge
favor,
shots from Mo there.
And Mo losing part of his blade. Warhead causing damage. More pieces off from Mo. He's down to half a blade. Warhead. Oh, Warhead's up against the ropes. He could get knocked out.
Oh, can he finish?
Mo trying to move in for a quick knockout. He's got it.
With half his blade. Unbelievable.
And just like that, Warhead is out. Cole, we gotta look at the few replays we got. What happened?
Well, remember when Mo fought Minotaur and got that big hit? He got two big ones off early, giving himself a huge edge. Another major scout for him. Well done, Mo.
Well, would you believe it? We've had two of Season 2's semifinalists upset tonight. Witch Doctor and Warhead are out of the competition. Cole, it's getting crazy this year. We're seeing bots like Black Ice and Mo go farther than I think anyone would have expected. You having fun? No, allow it. You ready to come back next week to see the rest of the round of 32?
Yeah.
All right. We'll see you guys next time. for the rest of the round of 32. It's going to be fun. Bronco, Sonoyachi, Tombstone. Bye! Why don't you meet me?